When you have 500 home runs at age 34, when you have your health and the quickest wrists in baseball, people start expecting miracles, like another 215 home runs before you call it quits. Babe Ruth's immortal record? Forget it, said most of the fans. And in this 1969 interview, Hank had to agree with them.
No, to be frank with you, I never did even consider myself as being a home run hitter, but I suppose the longer you stay up in the big leagues and the older you get, the stronger you get and the wiser you get, you know. So I never did. When I first came up, I didn't consider myself strong enough. In fact, I didn't even think I ever would be. You know, I came up as a skinny kid, weighing about 160-some pounds, so I really didn't think that I had a chance of ever getting close to Babe Ruth's record.
Baseball fans could always rattle off hammering Hank's statistics. How in 1969, he hit 44 home runs for the fourth time in his career to lead the Braves to the Western Division title. How in 1970, he collected base hit number 3,000. But baseball fans know everything. Just ask one. Suddenly, it wasn't just the ardent fan, but the average man on the street who knew about Hank Aaron and the home run countdown to Babe Ruth's record. Maybe it was April 27th, the date the hammer belted number 600, that the impossible began to seem possible.
Aaron waiting. Perry delivers to him. Swung on. Fly ball left field. Back goes Henderson. This may be. It is going, but it's not.
Gaylord kind of gave me the necessary incentive that I needed, you know, because I think he came out with a statement saying that in order, you know, for Henry, you know, he have to earn it, you know, if he hit it off me. And I just was really, for some reason, I was just up for the ball game. You know, I felt good that night, and I felt like I was going to swing the bat real good, and was just hoping that I could hit it off Gaylord.
Early in 1972, Aaron, now ranked number 3 in the all-time home run hit parade, hit number 649 to move up to number 2. As usual, the hammer did it with style. A bases-loaded shot that tied the National League record of 14 Grand Slam home runs.
Bases are loaded for Henry Aaron. Would this be a good spot for the hammer to break out of it? Aaron is 0 for 2 tonight and 5 for 51. Overdue is an understatement. And there it goes! Way back! Going! Grand Slam! They're standing here in Philadelphia, giving Hank the big hand, 649, puts him in second place. Mays has 648. Listen to the hand, everyone greeting him, as Hank just hit one out of here. That's his 10th of the year, 649 career-wise.
Ask Hank Aaron about his most memorable round-trippers, and he'll tell you about his 17th All-Star game, the one in 1972, before the hometown fans in Atlanta.
Well, here is Hank Aaron. 20 home runs, 659, 0 for 2 tonight, up against Gaylord Perry, who has only given up 6 home runs all year. So Perry is tough to hit the home run off of, but Aaron hits them off of everybody. There's the ball, hit the deep left field. Yastrzemski goes back near the wall. Looks up. He goes up. It's
gone. The Atlanta fans showed how they felt about their hometown hero with 3 standing ovations that night. Later, the hammer showed how he felt about them.
That was great, really. That was the greatest thing ever happened to me. And that's no lie. They talk about fans, but the people here in Atlanta has really been great to me.
That was the fireworks for 1972. That was the end of the fun. Because after that All-Star game, Hank Aaron hit only 14 more homers. After the greatest year of his career in 71, 1972 was a year of disappointment. His .265 batting average was the lowest of his career, and his RBI total was the lowest since his rookie year. Fans everywhere wondered if it was all over. Was Hank Aaron just too old? Suddenly, Babe Ruth's record, which had looked so vulnerable, was back where they said it would be, safe in the pages of history. 1973 didn't start off any better than 72 had ended. After 1 month, Hank was batting only 125. It was clear he was pressing, and the pressure finally made him crack. As the team left on a road trip, Hank Aaron fired off this emotional and unusual outburst at the ungrateful fans who were harassing him.
I've been harassed by a number of fans. I've been harassed as far as every time someone mentioned the word baseball, it seemed like I'm the whole source of the reason Atlanta Braves in last place, and it just seemed like the whole thing is on my shoulders, and I don't think it's been very fair. The last two or three weeks that I have been harassed, and first people calling me names and being very, very, very much nasty with me in the outfield and calling me just plain downright nasty, that's all. You know, after playing this game for 20 years and the credentials that you leave and the earmarks and everything else, it just feel like you don't really deserve this kind of treatment.
The response was, we love Hank.
The babe is up there watching Hank, and he's going to be proud of you. And everybody in baseball and around the world is going to love you. But Hank, as a pal and a fellow with a lot at stake, I've got just one request to make.
Hey, Hank, I know you're going to do it, but please don't hit it off of me. Hey, Hank, I've got a reputation and I've got a family. So please don't hit it, please don't hit it, please don't hit it off of me.
Thousands of fans wrote letters and cheered him on, and their encouragement was just what the Hammer needed.
Dear Mr. Aaron, please beat Babe this year so I can get these Cub fans off my back. It's kind of hard being a Braves fan in the middle of Chicago.
Even Mrs. Babe Ruth let Hank know she was with him.
I think that he deserves it. Hank Aaron is setting a record of his own for someone else to shoot at. And as far as I'm concerned, there's only one Babe, and he stands alone, and always will.
By July, Aaron was closing in on 700 home runs. He was attacking the ball now. He didn't feel his age. He felt good.
Well, I've been very careful not to play as many games as I have been playing. I feel a lot stronger than I did, say, last year or 2 years ago. I feel like I'm waiting on the ball, and when I get my pitch, I feel like I'm hitting it. When you're 39 years old and you're hitting the ball as well as I am, I have to feel proud, you know, because I feel like it hasn't been that many people that played the game at 39 and can say that at this stage or this time of the season that they can have 24, 25 home runs.
The week before the All-Star break, Hank Aaron passed yet another milestone.
Scene is set. Aaron with 699 career home runs. Huge turnout in left field seats, bringing nets, hoping to catch a home run. The 1-1. Swanson, here's a drive. Deep left field. This ball is going, and it's gone. 700 for Hank Aaron. Here he comes. They're standing at Atlanta Stadium. In one of the great events of history, Hank Aaron has just hit home run number 700. Only the second player in this great game ever to do it. He's being greeted at the dugout by all his teammates. There'll be a standing ovation here for minutes, I'm sure. He hit it deep into the seats in left field. There was no doubt about it. It got up in the pavilion about 10 or 15 rows. They're still standing and cheering as Aaron has socked one here in the bottom half of the third inning. 700 career-wise. He's now 14 away from the magic number of 714, and that is Babe Ruth's record.
After the All-Star break, Hank collected 701 in late July. He then went 16 days without a home run. Just when interest in his pursuit of the Babe was starting to fade, he belted 3 in 3 days. By the end of August, he was within 8. He opened September with 2 home runs against the Padres. 4 days later came 709. The next homer, 4 days later, with Milo Hamilton describing it.
Stretch pitch to the Hammer, and there's a drive. Going, going, and it's 710 in Atlanta Stadium. So they've got to change the big Henry Aaron scoreboard in left field in the bullpen. That's 710. The magic number is now 4 to tie, 5 to break the Ruth record.
Then Hank went a week before the next one.
Line drive, left field. That goal is going and gone. It's 7-11. A line drive home run above the teepee. You had to wait for it to go by the pole because it was hooking. It's a line drive home run, and it's 7-11.
7-12 was hit 4 days later in Houston. The Braves returned home with 5 games left. Hank failed to connect the first 2 nights against the Dodgers, and the third game was rained out. Now the pressure was really on.
You really don't know how much pressure that is, you know, to get to the plate and knowing that you got maybe 15, 16,000 people up there waiting for you to hit a ball out of the ballpark, and you just lose all your concentration at the plate, you know, knowing that if you don't do it, even if you get a base hit with the bases loaded, that they're disappointed, you know. But you just, things just don't come that way. You know, you go up there trying to do the best you can and hoping that you can hit the ball hard.
How much was it affecting Hank? Teammates like Darrell Evans were in the best position to judge that.
I think I've seen a few little things, but maybe before I had noticed them. Nothing real noticeable or anything like that, but just, you know, he's been kind of keeping away from everybody, of course, because there's so many people around him. But, you know, in the dugout, I've seen him a couple times now where he's not really showing anger or anything, but kind of frustration, you know, and I think he wants it so bad that, you know, you got to go through something like that. He's gotten so close, and just going in there over there with all the reporters over there is, was just something that, I tell you, it's got to be hard for him to take. I know the pressure's on him anyway, and you go in a room, something like that, and the questions they ask and the things he's got to come up with to say, it's unbelievable the type of guy that he's stayed the same way over the last 4 or 5 years since I've known him.
Saturday night, September 29th, the next to the last game of the season for the Braves. It was Aaron's 40th homer. Evans with 41, Johnson with 43, gave the Braves 3 hitters with 40 or more, the first team to ever achieve that distinction.
Davey and Darrell have had great years, you know, a great season, both of them, you know, and I think the competition between the three of us was great. You know, it was a friendly type competition, you know. I'm just happy to see Darrell, you know, have the kind of season that he had simply because players like Dusty Baker and Ralph Garza, the future of Atlanta Braves.
So the stage was set for the final day of the season. In the clubhouse before the game, Carl Morton reflected the players' feelings.
Today is a very, very exciting day, and with a big crowd out there, we all are pulling for him to do it, to set the record today, and I think if there is a feeling, the feeling of electricity, is that he will do it. He will get that home run today, at least a tie, because Hank seems to do things as though it were written on a script, and the script dictates definitely that he get that 714 today.
Somehow the script was altered. Hank singled 3 times before popping up to the second baseman, leaving him 1 shy.
I am disappointed, yes, but I feel like I got all year and I all want to go home and rest up. It's been a tiresome year for me, you know, really. For the last month, I would say, it's been really tiresome, just, you know, the same things and... But I feel a little relieved now that it's over with. And, of course, if I got some good pitches to hit today, I thought maybe I might have hit a home run.
Hank wanted that 714th homer, and he wanted it bad.
I was going for the home run, and this is the first time that I can honestly say that I was going for it, you know, and simply because I think 45,000 people come out here to see me hit a home run.
When the whole world is counting your every home run, you think back to the ones that got away.
Well, that one was called by umpire Chris Pelakoulas. We were playing in St. Louis at the time, and of course, Curt Simmons, whom I still think is probably the greatest pitcher that ever pitched against me consistently, you know, over a period of years, getting me out. He threw me a lot of changeups, and we were playing Old Busch Stadium, and he had been giving me a lot of trouble that day, and so I decided I would move up in the batter's box, do something a little different. So I'd hit balls. I hit a couple singles off him. So the last time up, I hit a ball right field. That was a home run. That didn't count. And Chris said I was out of the batter's box. So you can't hit a ball when you're out of the batter's box. But I thought I was in the batter's box. And that's the only time I ever came close from being thrown out of a ball game.
After the hectic pace and pressure of the 73 season had wound down, Hank Aaron took the offseason to wind himself down. It was only then that he could think and talk reflectively about his role as an Atlanta Brave versus his role in history.
I have always been lucky in that respect as having been surrounded by some great hitters, you know. Of course, Matthews and the Adcocks and the Crandalls and the Brutons and the Covingtons. So I've always been surrounded by great hitters, you know, and this always have helped me out because if you can recall, most of your great hitters way back, home run hitters such as Ruth and also Mantle and also even Willie Mays, you know, for years. I would say that they've always been 1-2 punches in the lineup, you know. But you just can't be a home run hitter by yourself.
When the pressure is off, that's when you can really talk about pressure and how you handle it.
I don't feel like I've been playing under pressure. I feel like I have a job to do, and regardless to whether it means that hitting against someone that I think I can hit the ball out of the ballpark or playing against another pitcher that I think is going to give me some trouble, you know, if I can help the ball club win a ball game, this is the utmost important to me.
Sports, like life, is filled with irony. Hank Aaron fought prejudice in his early years because some people thought he wasn't the white man's equal. Now he had to fight prejudice because he was surpassing a white man named George Herman Ruth. Soon it was time to think about the 74 season and the final chapter of the race against Ruth. In this interview, recorded at his final spring training, Hank Aaron talked of all the other hitting records he was proud of.
No one ever talks about him. You know, the only thing that they talk about, of course, is a home run. And this is what people always seem to bring out, you know. And so I don't mention those other records, but I'm very happy and I'm conscious of the fact that I'm just as close as I am. Even before this home run thing came out, you know, I've always said when I got my 3,000 hit in Cincinnati, I said that to accomplish that is quite a feat, you know, because it's very few ball players and it's some great ball players. And I'm speaking about some real great ball players that's in the Hall of Fame that hasn't accomplished that feat, you know. And I'm well aware of the fact, and I'm tickled that I've been able to accomplish that, get well over 3,000 hits, and also maintain a 300 of old batting average.
No opening day in baseball history attracted as much worldwide attention as opening day 1974. Unfortunately, along with the excitement and the honors due Hank Aaron, there was controversy. It was no longer, will Hank hit it? It was, where will Hank hit it? Commissioner Bethune ruled that Aaron must play in the opening three-game series in Cincinnati, possibly denying Hank's hometown fans the thrill of watching the two home runs they'd waited so long to see. If you lived in Atlanta, you held your breath as number 44 stepped to the plate in Cincinnati's Riverfront Stadium.
Runners lead, Billingham. Stretches and pitches. Swung on, driven, deep left field. Back goes Wolf. He's at the track, just falling, going, and it's gone! 7-14! Hank Aaron on his first at bat here at Riverfront, and over 50,000 on their feet. And the whole team coming to home plate.
Good luck for 7-15 and a good many more. It's a great day for you. It's a great day for baseball. The best to you.
Vice President, Commissioner, Mr. Bartholomew, I certainly would like to say thank you very much, and I'm just glad it's almost over with. Thank you.
Hank Aaron out game number two, went 0-for-3 in game three, and headed home to Atlanta and history.
And here is Henry Aaron. This crowd is up all around. The pitch to him, bounced it up there, and it's ball one. In the second inning, walked and scored. He's sitting on 7-14. Here's the pitch by Downing. Swinging. There's a drive into left center field. That ball is going to be out of here. It's gone. It's 7-15. There's a new home run champion of all time, and it's Henry Aaron. The fireworks are going. Henry Aaron is coming around third. His teammates are at home, and listen to this crowd. A sellout crowd is cheering Henry Aaron, the home run king of all time. 7-15 came on a ball one, no strike count. It was into left center. Bill Buckner, the left fielder, tried to go up and get it. He climbed the fence. He couldn't get it. The ball was into the grass, just to the right of the bullpen. And this ball game is tied on the strength of the record-setting home run by Henry Aaron. How about that? Aaron's home run to the power alley in left center field. This crowd is going crazy. Now Henry is over by his lovely wife, Billy, over by his parents and the rest of his family. And brother, I want to tell you, he has set this baseball crowd on its ear and the fireworks filling the sky over Atlanta Stadium. Yes, Henry Aaron has done it at the age of 40. Babe Ruth was 40 when he hit 714. And Henry Aaron, who 2 years ago seriously announced that he was going to challenge the great Bambino, has done it here tonight, Monday night, April the 8th, 1974. And now the game will be delayed for ceremonies in the on-deck circle to the right, where Chairman of the Board of the Atlanta Braves, Bill Bartholomew, will make a presentation, and we'll hope that we can pick it up. This is the moment they've been waiting for. This is why this was a sellout crowd. Everybody came hoping that tonight would be the night. It turned out to be just that. Looking around in this crowd, there everybody's up, over 50,000 here. He's surrounded by photographers. And as Henry will probably say in a moment or two, I'm glad it's over. It has been a rough, rough trip.
Not only a plaque, but a special ring that his fans and admirers from all over this country, through me, have asked to be made. It's a diamond ring with a replica of Hank, the Atlanta Stadium, and it will be marked April 8, 1974, to the greatest ball player, the finest gentleman, Mr. Hank Aaron. Thank you. Thank you.
I just thank God it's all over with. Thank you very much.
And so the record that they set in our lifetime, or maybe any time, could never be broken, has in fact been broken.
48 hours after the record breaker, Hank had a moment of reflection.
Records are made to be broken. I'm hoping that in my time before I die that I can see some young kid come along and be black or white, come along and challenge and break my record. You know, I would hope so.
But Hank, one thing you definitely can't say anymore, and that is that you haven't been recognized.
Well, that's true. That's true. And sometime I wished it hadn't came, but I suppose I was getting a little sick and tired of it, you know, being second best all the time and people saying, well, you know, Mickey Mantle or Roger Maris or Herman Killebrew or Willie Mays and all those players have a chance to break Babe Ruth's record. And they say, oh, by the way, they got a player down in Atlanta or a player in Milwaukee. He may have a chance, you know. And I suppose I just got a little sick and tired of it, and I was determined to try and do the best that I could and try to accomplish the one record that probably would make people recognize me, and especially the news media, you know, because they always said if you didn't play in New York City, you would never be recognized as a ball player, you know. And it takes a monument occasion like what I just did for a ball player to be recognized in some respect. And I've always considered myself, you know, I just didn't get those 3,000 hits by not being a complete ball player. I didn't steal 200 bases by not being a complete ball player. I have three golden gloves hanging up in my locker, you know. So all of those things would identify me with a complete ball player, but it took one thing, one home run, one thing for me to challenge in order for people, and I'm speaking about the news media, to recognize and say, well, now he's a great ball player, he's a superstar.
How do you end an album about a man whose career has not ended and whose greatness will never end? We're not talking merely about baseball greatness, because Hank has already announced that 1974 is his last season. We're talking about the impact his life has had on all of sports history. And the example his life has set for fans, for youngsters, for people who somehow, in some way, have had their lives changed by this man. Well, there you have it. The key hits and career highlights of Henry Louis Aaron, history's all-time home run king, the life of a legend.